In this lesson, we're going to learn about mirroring, so let's get started. Remember, go File, New, Part, select Options, Document Properties, Units, and as usual, I'm going to do it in inches. Mirroring is used when you have a part with lots of dimensions and features, but it's symmetric on both sides. It saves a lot of time and makes it easy to make changes. So let's see how we do that. I'm just going to select the front plane, right click, sketch. And to make things easy, I usually select a center line first. And we can also do a horizontal one as well. Now I'm going to do a fairly simple part, but it's going to have a few dimensions. And we actually did a shape like this in one of our previous episodes. If you remember from our other episodes, it's important to make sure that you have dimensions and relations on your sketch. So let's do that. We're going to hit Smart Dimension. And we'll make this 6 inches. And then we need a height. And 4.5 looks good. We need to make sure that these two lines are parallel. We're going to need a few more dimensions. And it may take you some time to figure out all the dimensions you need, but that's okay. And now you can see our part is locked, so all of our dimensions are set and nothing can be moved because you see the black, all the lines are black. Now watch what happens when we select mirror. So in Sketch, we have the mirror tool, which will allow us to duplicate everything you see. So hit mirror entities, entities to mirror. Obviously we're going to select all our lines. And then we're going to mirror about that line that we already selected. And now we have a symmetric part. And as usual, we can go Features, Extrude Base, and we'll just make it 1/2 inch thick. Now that we have a symmetric part, let's do a little more mirroring to our features, just so we can get a hang of it. So remembering from our other episodes, we select this surface, we're gonna hit Sketch, and we can do normal too, just so it's facing us. We'll zoom in a little bit. And now I'm going to put another center line. I'm going to lock this one in. And the other thing I'm going to do is draw two more center lines in the center of this. Now these don't have to end any particular place. We're just using them as reference. First, we're going to put a circle in the center. Now that one's not going to get mirrored, obviously. So we'll just make it 1 inch. But then we're going to draw a couple of more circles. Let's do 1, 2. Remember, we have to dimension it or add relations, so we'll make them all the same size. And then we're going to give a dimension between each of those. There's a number of ways to do this, but for this episode, this makes it easy. And then we'll just do one more. Just clean up our dimensions a little bit. So now we have three circles. And just like we did before, we're gonna wanna mirror those. So we hit mirror. Entities to mirror, we're just doing these two. And we're going to mirror about this line. And there you have it. Now we have the circles, we can go features, extruded cut, and through all. And there you go. Now we could continue on and add some more features, but you get the idea of how easy it is to mirror within Sketches. I hope you've enjoyed this episode and join me again for more 5-minute tutorials on how to use SolidWorks. Don't forget to subscribe.